Friends,
what's up?
Welcome back. We're doing this, guys. We are doing it. I am trying my best to give you guys one video a week, but I need your help. If you guys have content you would like to see, please let me know because I feel sometimes stuck on what to share with you guys. But I have an exciting topic for today, and I think it could be really helpful. As always, my experience in business is through the coffee shop and photography. So most of what I'm going to share comes from that lens, no pun intended. However, I think that a lot of these things that I share with you guys could work for multiple small businesses. So if you are not looking to open a coffee shop or run a photography business, while I may speak in terms of those things, I do believe that this advice could help you guys and help you with whatever business you're hoping to open. Today's topic we're going to talk about is all of the different apps that I use to run our businesses and how we use those apps and in what terms we use them. And I think that this one will be huge for you guys. As you know, social media is a huge, huge, huge part of successful businesses in today's digital world. We all see all the ads on Facebook and Instagram. I'm sure we all follow different companies on Facebook and Instagram, even Pinterest without realizing it. We're getting hit with ads on there as well. And I just feel like if you are not utilizing these apps, you are really missing out. And so I want to help you guys with just the tools that we use and how to better use those social media platforms for your business. I'm also going to talk about some other apps that we use that are really helpful and that honestly could not run our business without, so stay tuned for that as well. Okay, first up, Facebook and Instagram. If you are not on Facebook and Instagram for your business, I don't care about your personal life, just business alone, you truly are missing out. And I highly suggest that you guys are utilizing Facebook and Instagram daily. On our last video, if you haven't watched that one yet, you should hop back. But on our last video, we talked about the difference between doing a sprint and a marathon and how that makes a huge difference in the success of your company. Another example that I wanted to share with you guys that I was talking to Casey about, and we both laughed and we were like, oh my gosh, I should have mentioned this in the last video. When you're looking at that sprint versus marathon mentality, a good other way to imagine this is if, let's say you wanted to get in shape, okay? You have a whole year to get into shape. You're like, I'm gonna get in the best shape of my life this year. If you go to the gym for 2 weeks, two times a day, you're dieting hard, you're losing weight, you're doing rocking job for 2 weeks, and then you don't go the rest of the year, that is going to be way worse for you than if you went just one time a week and you fixed your diet just 1/10 of what it was before. You will end up losing and sustaining more weight loss or a better physique over that year than if you went so hard for 2 weeks and then never went again. Even so hard for 1 month and never went again. So think of your business in the same way. Yes, it's going to take some extreme grit and it's going to take a lot of energy and excitement at the start. And just like I said in the last video, it's okay to start out sprinting, but as long as you find that pace and find it pretty quickly, then you can maintain that pace throughout the entire process of your business. Good things take time. Great things take longer. Just remember that. It's not going to happen overnight. It's not going to be an overnight success. And I think that so many people look at businesses today, and granted, there are the weird outliers. There are the random people who start a business and within 1 month, it's a multi-million dollar business. That's amazing. We could all learn something from them. However, the majority of us are putting in the effort every single day, chipping away at the business every single day. And over time, we'll have slow and sustainable growth. And that growth is not going to be like the 10 pounds we lose in our 2 week workout. It's going to be that long over the year weight loss. And we can maintain that a lot easier. So for Facebook and Instagram, rounding this out, I suggest posting once a day, every day. And you're thinking, how in the world do I even come up with ideas once a day, every single day? Let me share my second app that I use. Now, I did do a video about this before, so some of you may remember this video before. If you haven't, I'll try to put the little thing up there for you so you can go click on that video and look at this as well. But the app that I use to help us to post once a day, every day, is an app called Planoly. And guess what, guys? They actually did reach out to me about being an ambassador. So now I can share a code below if you'd like to check it out. Obviously, I think that the code, I'm not sure if there's a perk for you guys. I need to look into that more. But it's just a nice kickback if you guys do decide to use my code below. It just helps me to get a free month, I believe. So that would be amazing. No pressure, honestly. I'd rather you guys just use it and enjoy it. And I love the company, and I promoted them well before they asked if I wanted to be an ambassador. So Planoly is amazing. I will show you guys on my phone, and I don't know if how bad the glare is going to be and stuff. So if it's terrible, I apologize. Right now I have the account pulled up for my photography, but I just want to show you kind of what the app looks like. Focus, there we go. So it looks honestly just like Instagram, but you can see in the corner there's little pink U's, and those pink U's stand for unplanned. So basically what it allows me to do is to add photos into my grid, and then I can take the photos and I can drag them around and I can move them around to see how I want our grid to look. For a business like a coffee shop, your grid is important, but it's definitely not as important as a photographer. For me as photography, this is essentially like a mini portfolio. My clients are going to my Instagram, they're looking at my images, and they're wanting to see that the feed looks cohesive, looks good, represents what they want for their wedding. For the coffee shop, I feel like it's less about how cohesive your feed looks and more just about ideas for drinks, happy customers, merch, things like that, that really just get, for us, like barista, on the top of their mind. So for you guys, it's more just the fact that you're posting every single day. They're seeing your brand. Just like they say, you know, if you see a Coca-Cola sign every single day, doesn't mean you're necessarily gonna pull over right now and grab a Coca-Cola, but when you do get thirsty and you go to a gas station, you open up the fridge, because you've seen Coca-Cola so many times and you have that brand recognition, Coca-Cola is going to be your first choice. And so same thing with your coffee shop. I just suggest that you're posting regularly and good content, because when that person is craving a coffee, they're going to see your post. Now, however, I must share with you guys that with barista, we have noticed a huge trend that if we post a coffee or a drink or whatever on our Instagram and Facebook, within the hour, we will have people coming in, showing us the image and telling us, I want this, or new merch drops. They're in there within an hour saying, you know, we're here for the new shirt or we're here for the new sticker. So barista is very impulsive in that sense, that people are ready to convert right away. People are very visual. I think we all know this. We're all guilty of this, right? When we see the juicy hamburger on the billboard, we're like, man, that looks good and I want that, right? And so for barista, it's really important that we're posting pictures of drinks that just look great. People love like the frappes and the iced coffees, really colorful things like our Red Bull Blast. People are really drawn to those types of drinks. So I just suggest always posting like, this one looks awesome. It's an eggnog latte. So we just took the shots of espresso, added in the eggnog, and quickly took a picture before it got stirred. And that one had a great interaction. And we get a lot of people who come in and they literally do this. I want this. And they show you the phone. So just as a heads up, like it's good to post for brand recognition, but it's also good to get immediate results of people wanting impulsive. They're sitting at home. They're like, I'm kind of tired, kind of bored. And then you post that photo of that drink, they will be there really fast. So Facebook and Instagram, huge. Planoly, also huge. Here's the other perk to Planoly that I love. You can click on the image and you get to write out your caption. So to write out your caption, you have saved hashtags. So if you use hashtags like, for us, you know, hashtag Idaho, hashtag your local coffee shop, hashtag espresso, all these people that we're trying to reach, you actually can click on that little hashtag button and it has different groupings of hashtags saved for you. And so you just click on that button, you click on the hashtags, and it will add the hashtags into your post automatically. You do not have to type them out every single time, which is a huge perk and an amazing thing that you guys should look into. The other thing that you're able to do is tag location. So you could always have it saved to have your location saved and tagged. For us, you know, we like to tag not only the coffee shop as a location, but also Mountain Home Idaho, because that's where we're at. And so if anyone's looking at Mountain Home Idaho as a location, we may pop up. So that's another thing. The last thing that I love about Planoly is that you can schedule the posts out. You have to have a business account, just mind that. You can't have a creator account or a personal account, but if you have a business account, it allows you to schedule the posts. So for me, I do not want to wake up every single morning and post our post at 5:30 in the morning. So I always schedule our post out and then it automatically posts our post at 5:30 in the morning and I don't have to do anything with it. I schedule it, leave it alone, and it's done. Some months I'm really on top of my game and I actually schedule out the entire month. So then I don't have to worry about our posts getting scheduled throughout the entire month. I don't have to do it every single day. I literally do it one time and then they all post throughout the month. Other months, a little more difficult depending on how much stuff I have going on, and I end up scheduling the posts every single day. Okay, I apologize if you guys could hear Casey on a phone call in the background. I was trying to talk loudly so that you guys didn't hear him, but you know, when we both work from home, there's just only so much you can do. Okay, moving on to our next app. This app is called 7Shifts, and this is the app that we use to keep track of all of our employees. It also helps us keep track of the schedule and allow us to message employees back and forth and not having to use like text messages. So 7Shifts is an app that you can download on iOS or on Android. So when you open up 7Shifts, the first thing that you'll see is actually who is currently clocked in. For privacy, I'm not going to turn my phone around and show you who's clocked in, but it allows us to see who is clocked in. I can toggle between both locations. So we currently have two locations. You can add multiple locations on. So I can see who's working at both shops at all times. I also have the ability to click on a button called the schedule. And so I can see who is all scheduled. At our coffee shop, we schedule for the next month. So by the 25th of the month, we schedule for the entire next month. So employees are able to see the entire schedule for their entire month. There's actually a really cool feature here at the top. It says overview and it says my shifts. You can click on the my shifts and it will show the employee all of the shifts that they have for that month. It'll tell them what location they're working at. We actually make our employees just stay at one location. If we're gonna make a change, they'll change for the entire month. But it's nice that they can just see straight down exactly all the shifts that they have. We personally, without trying to open a can of worms, we personally do not share the entire schedule with every employee. They can only access the shifts that they have. However, our shift leaders have access to the full schedule. We dealt a little bit in the past with people just kind of like going into work with an expectation based off of who they knew they were working with. And we found that when people only had access to their own schedule, that it really brought them in with an open mind and they just showed up to work excited to work their shift and were less focused about who they were working with or how many hours their coworkers were getting in comparison to them. That was just a positive change that we made and we felt like it was a good change. So we love that 7Shifts has the ability to restrict so that people can only see the shift that they are working. The other function that we love is the messaging function. You can quickly send out an announcement to the entire company, or you can send out messages specifically to the people working a certain shift, a certain store, a certain day. It's really nice to be able to have that function, or you can just message people individually. People do get the notification on their phone. They also can get a text message that alerts. Another function we love is that it sends them a notification 1 hour before their shift that just reminds them, hey, you work in 1 hour, have a great shift. Love that. I feel like it saved us a couple of times when people just weren't quite sure that they worked, although they had access to the calendar and all their shifts. It's just a nice little backup safety that it says, hey, 1 hour you work. Last function on 7Shifts that I'd like to talk about is that it has the ability to have a shift pool. At first, we did not utilize the shift pool just because we liked that the people would have to come to their manager and say, I need this shift covered, I'm sick, my child is sick, something came up type of thing. And then the manager would go out and specifically find someone to cover that shift for them. We just felt like it was nice to have control kind of over who worked the shifts in the sense that we just know certain teams work better together than others. And so we just wanted to make sure that whoever was covering the shift was going to fit well in the team for that day. Since we have decided just to make my managers' lives a little bit easier, since they were so like having to find people to cover all these shifts all the time themselves, we now utilize the shift pool. Our company policy is that you have to contact the manager and say, this came up, this is why I need my shift covered. And then the manager will put your shift into the shift pool. So our regular baristas and shift leaders are not able to put their own shifts into the shift pool. The manager has to do it for them. Once the shift pool goes out, people can bid on whether they'd like the shift or not. It goes out company-wide, so people are able to bid on that shift. And even like how we have two stores, someone from a different store could bid on that shift. It's great because there are times where people really, you know, are looking for extra hour opportunities. And so by putting it out in the shift pool, it allows them to pick up those hour opportunities. It also helps us a lot because this way the manager isn't calling every single person saying, are you available to cover this shift? It just puts it out there and people can choose if they want to take it or not. And then if we have an issue where no one's taking it, then we'll go further to try to figure out a solution. Okay, Connected to 7 Shifts is actually a separate app, but same company, and it's called 7 Punches. 7 Punches, just like I said, you have to have a 7 Shifts account in order to have a 7 Punches account as well, but 7 Punches allows our employees to log in and out of work, to clock in and out, I guess, and they get a PIN number assigned to them when they become part of the company. And so when they get into work, they open up 7 Punches and they put in their PIN and it says they're clocked in. When they leave, they put in their PIN again and it clocks them out. This is great for those of you who are doing the back end side of this, which is trying to figure out payroll and calculating hours. It does it all for you. The thing that's nice too is since 7 Shifts and 7 Punches are connected, you can verify and cross-reference if someone was scheduled, let's say 11 to 4, and then they forgot to clock in or something. You have both referenced together and they work together so that you can figure out, you know, if someone worked a certain time or not. You can figure out if someone covered a shift for someone else and that's why that one person didn't clock in and someone else clocked in at that time instead. They work together and it's a great seamless grouping. We have really, really, really enjoyed 7 Shifts and 7 Punches, and I know there are several other coffee shops and restaurants who use this system as well. It comes highly recommended from us and it has transformed how we do everything. Last function, I guess, before I let you guys go on this one, things just keep popping up in my mind of reasons that we love it. It allows people to go in and insert 2 things, availability and time off requests. So for us, we let them know availability is something that is reoccurring. Essentially, if we have an employee who has daycare available from 6 a.m. until 6 p.m., then their availability is from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m., let's say Monday through Friday. And then on the weekends, maybe it's more open. So when they submit an availability, it's something that's going to be a repeating process that's not going to change, at least for that month. Or even you can do it weekly, but I would say anything that's reoccurring for more than 1 week, we consider availability. On the contrary, you have time off requests. And time off requests can be anything from just, I have a 1 hour nail appointment on Tuesday at 3 and you need that hour off. Or I'm going to be on vacation, I'll be gone for this weekend, I need from Friday until Sunday off. We always encourage our employees that the more specific they are on those time off requests, the more that we're able to schedule them. So let's say they do have a nail appointment at 3 on Tuesday, we could still have them open from 5 a.m. until 11 a.m. or close, and they would still be able to get a shift that day. Plus it opens up our chances to fill our schedule up and have a little easier time scheduling versus them taking off the entire day just because they have a 1 hour nail appointment. So what's really cool is that once all your employees submit their availability, for us, we have a cutoff date and that's the 20th. They have to have all their availability and time off requests put in. Nothing for us is guaranteed just because we try our best to make sure that everyone gets fair and equal opportunities to take vacations and have time off. And so they submit those requests by the 20th. The schedule comes out on the 25th. My managers go into the back end of 7 Shifts and they can approve or deny time off. You're able to write a note on why you can approve it or deny it. And once they've approved or denied all the time off, then there's a button that says auto populate schedule. and it just throws people into the schedule based off of their availability and time off. Once the schedule is auto-populated, it is so much easier for the managers to be able to just go in and move people around based off of who we know works really well together, or if we need to add a person or move something around to make life easier. It has made our scheduling system so much easier. It has eliminated the need to just handwrite it all and try to work out people's availability and keeping track of who is available and who is not. It also puts the responsibility on the employee to submit that availability and that time off request, because they know when it is supposed to be turned in by, and they know that if they don't have it in by that certain date, that there's really not much we can do because the schedule comes out. Granted, if we always need to add a shift to the shift pool for someone to take that based off of an emergency situation, we absolutely will. But it has made our life so much easier, and it has made it so much easier for the employees to keep track of when they work and to be able to get a hold of fellow employees. It has been a lifesaver. So 7 shifts and 7 punches, highly suggest both of those for you guys. Another app that we couldn't live without is one that we use primarily just on the iPads at work, and that is Lavvu. It is our point of sale system that we are currently using. This has changed in the past and may continue to change in the future. However, I know a lot of you have reached out asking what point of sale system that we use. Right now we are using Lavvu. We use Heartland Processing Payment System. It's a credit card merchant processing system, and Lavvu was who they were partnering with at the time. However, Heartland just released another app that they're working on, and we are considering switching to that one. However, Lavvu has been great. They've been great to work with. It's an app that you use on an iPad. This is something that I personally enjoy, and I think that you guys should consider doing this as well, is consider doing a point of sale system that is based off of a cloud. The reason for this is because if an iPad ever were to break or get lost or damaged or stolen, you are not out your entire menu and having to regenerate an entire menu from the start. So for us, we had an iPad get dropped and got broken one time. All we had to do was go buy a new iPad, and we just had to log into our Lavvu account, and our entire menu was there. We did have to have it authorized by the point of sale just so that they know that there's, you know, only 2 going on at one time. However, life was so much easier. This is also great if you're looking to expand and open new locations. You have to build your menu one time, and then you always can just update it from there, and the updates can be done on your phone. I constantly am updating our Lavvu point of sale because let's say we have like a new cup that comes out. When I added those new cups in the other day, I just go on my phone, log into our Lavvu account, I add the new cup on there, and it's just done. It's instant. The employees just have to reload the settings, and it's done. I don't have to go to every location just to make a change or update something. So if we do a special, like a $2 muffin top day, I can add a $2 muffin top button to the point of sales without having to actually go there and access it. The other thing that's nice is that I can access at any time how our sales are doing, what's selling, how many customers we served from a certain time to a certain time. This is really nice for scheduling. So like, let's say, when we were doing New Year's this year, we actually logged in and went and looked at how New Year's was last year. And we looked at what hours of the day were busy, what hours of the day were slower, and it helped us to create our schedule. My managers reached out and they were like, hey, how many customers did we serve from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. on New Year's Eve? Do I need a fourth person? And so I was able to go access that information just on my phone and send that over to them, and it made life a lot easier. So highly suggest a cloud-based point-of-sale system. You do not have to use Lavvu. However, like a restaurant-type style system is very helpful for a coffee shop. And there are several point-of-sale systems that are built just for coffee shops or restaurants. And I think that those will be the best option for you, just because with a coffee shop, we deal with a lot of modifications. So it's not just a latte, it's a latte with an extra shot and almond milk and, you know, all the little modifications. And that's one of the things that Lavvu does very well. I'll keep you guys updated if we do switch over to the new Heartland one and how that goes and what we think comparing Lavvu to the new Heartland one. Okay guys, that wraps up just a lot of the apps that we absolutely use every single day for our coffee shop, and why we use them and how we use them. If you guys have any questions on any of those apps, please drop them in the comments below, and I would love to help you guys through that. As always, thank you guys so much for watching and interacting with our videos. We hope that this information has been super helpful and is helping you on your own journey to opening your own coffee shop or other small business. We'll catch you guys back here soon. I'm shooting for one video a week, so I need your guys' help with that. Don't forget to drop those below for me so that I have content ideas. All right, see you soon.